Hello, everyone. Welcome to the English devotional from Soldiers of the Cross. Let's begin in prayer. Heavenly Father, I come before your holy presence asking forgiveness of my sins so my prayer can enter your throne. I glorify your holy name, Lord, because you are good, you are faithful, you are kind. Your mercies are new every morning. I thank you, Father God, that you are our comforter, that you are our counselor, that you give us wisdom when we need it, when we ask for it. I praise you, Father, because you are faithful to the promises that you have given to us. If we seek you, we will find you. If we ask forgiveness of our sins, you are faithful and you will forgive us of our sins. I thank you, Lord, for the cross of Calvary. Thank you for bearing our shame and our sins and our sorrows. Thank you because you have overcome the world, and we don't need to be afraid. We don't need to be discouraged because the victory is already yours. I thank you and I praise you because you know all things. You know our hearts, you know our troubles, you know our struggles, you know our joys and our triumphs and our victories, Lord. There is nothing hidden from your sight. I glorify your holy name. Lord, be with this devotional today. Bless those who are listening. Bless those who are taking to heart the things that they are hearing today. Father, I ask that you will give us wisdom to know how to apply it to our lives, Lord. May this be tangible. May this grow our spiritual lives. May we use it to bring you honor and glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Today's devotional is titled, Do Not Be Afraid. It was written by Eunice Perez Lopez and translated by Maria Elena Cardona. Our biblical base comes from Isaiah 41, verses 10 through 13. So says the word of God. Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Behold, all those who are incensed against you shall be ashamed and disgraced. They shall be as nothing. And those who strive with you shall perish. You shall seek them and not find them. Those who contend with you, those who war against you shall be as nothing, as a non-existent thing. For I, the Lord your God, will hold your right hand, saying to you, Fear not, I will help you. Amen. May we be blessed by the reading of the scripture. Many times in our lives, we have had moments of fear because we are human and we don't always have strength. I remember during my youth, I had a terrible accident. I was on a bus full of passengers going to Camagüey to Villa Clara in Cuba. My sister and I, together with others, were going to Sancti Spiritus for a special youth program. 13 kilometers from our destination, the bus overturned toward the gutter, landing wheels up. But while we were overturning, and as I watched, I shouted, My God, deliver us! In my mind, I heard these words, Do not be afraid. And by the grace of God, we only received a few bruises. I will never forget that experience. The psalmist said, Though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Faithful is the Almighty. If God is with us, who will be against us? Therefore, always trust, because our help comes from Jehovah. Do not worry. Amen. My brothers and sisters, it is so easy for us to say, Don't be afraid. It's so easy for us to say, Don't worry. But putting that into practice is different. It is hard to do. But you know, it is a mindset. Every time we start to worry, every time we start to be afraid, we have to remind ourselves of all the scriptures that we know about God's promises. We have to remind ourselves of the attributes of God, telling ourselves that we are not going to be afraid. We are going to choose to have faith and trust in God. We are going to choose to allow Him to be our strength, to allow Him to work things out. And little by little, those decisions to trust will turn into the feelings, and eventually they'll become second nature. For you not to be afraid, for you not to worry, because you know where your strength comes from. You know who is in charge and who is on the throne, but it takes time. So be patient with yourself. If you find yourself being afraid, if you find yourself being worried, don't lose heart. Don't be discouraged. Don't beat yourself up, because this is a process. It's not a light switch. This is a journey and a process, and you will get there to where whatever comes your way, you're not going to be afraid. Whatever comes your way, you're not going to worry, because your spiritual life is going to grow little by little, but it will grow. Amen. May the Lord receive the honor and the glory.
Oh,
Amen, what a beautiful song. And now we invite you to check out the YouTube channel SCC English Ministry for our daily Bible reading as we continue our journey through the Old Testament. And now we ask that the blessed love of God, the grace and peace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the companion and communion of the Holy Spirit, our great counselor, be with all of his children now and forever. Amen.